Good morning everybody and welcome to my class. And already I have told you how to find out the area of a triangle if base and height is given, and how to find out the area of a triangle if the length of three sides are given. And then I have told you everything in my previous video on equilateral triangle. And today I am going to tell you everything on isosceles triangle. And what is the meaning of isosceles triangle actually? So let us know about the isosceles angle. Isosceles angle means two sides should be equal. If the two sides are equal, then that angle is isosceles angle. Okay, see here ABC, in the triangle ABC, AB and AC are equal and BC is different side. And the angle corresponding to the equal sides, that means C and B will be equal in length, equal angles. And because AC and BC are equal in length, so the corresponding angles should be equal. And this is the base. And if you draw a perpendicular from A upon BC, so it will divide or it will bisect the base. So I am taking the length of equal side as A. Length of equal side. And B as length of unequal side. So this is A, I am taking. This is also A, and this total is B. So since AD divides the base or bisects the base, so this length will become B by 2 and this length will become B by 2. Okay, so what the perimeter of this isosceles angle? So let us see, perimeter is equal to A plus A plus B. That means 2A plus B. And perimeter I am taking P. Let the perimeter be denoted by P. So P is equal to 2A plus B. Okay. And if perimeter is given, and either A or B is given, here base is B I am taking. Okay. So basically the unequal side is the base generally. Okay. So base means B, and the lateral sides, that is A, equal sides. Okay. So length of unequal side, that is base is your P minus 2A. If perimeter is given, P minus 2A. Clear? And if perimeter is given and base is given, so how to find out length of equal side? It will be, take D to this side, it will become P minus B, then divided by 2. Okay, so length of equal side is equal to P minus B divided by 2. Okay, so now what is the height of the equilateral isosceles angle? Height is equal to, so apply the Pythagoras theorem to this triangle A, B, C. This is the hypotenuse, this is the base. Base is B by 2, hypotenuse is A. So how to find out AD, that is height? AD is equal to square of hypotenuse, that is A square, that is square of base, B square by 4. Because square of B by 2 is B square by 4, then take the root of 1. So simply take the LCM. It will become 4A square minus B square divided by 4, square root of this one. And square root of 4 is 2. So 1 by 2 I am taking outside. Then 4a square minus b square root of 4. So this is the height of the isosceles triangle, in which base is B, which is the different side, and length of equal side is A. Okay. So now area of the isosceles triangle. As you know, the first rule, half base into height. Half. And here base is B, and height is this one. So 1 by 2 into base, half base into height is this one. 1 by 2, that is 4 square minus b square root of 1. So half into half, it is 1 by 4 and b is there. So b by 4 into 4a square minus b square root of 1. So this is the area of the isosceles triangle, in which A and B are given. And what are A and B? Always remember the value of, what is the meaning of A and B? A is the length of equal side, that lateral sides, and B is the base, which is the different side, that means on equal side. Okay, so in this one, it is not necessary to give you some examples. Okay, so these are the direct formulas. Simply A and B will be given, perimeter will be given, and you can apply the formula directly. Simply apply the direct formula. Okay, so don't do indirectly or don't confuse, and there is no nothing to confuse. Okay, so if the length of equal side A is given and base is given B, then you can find out the perimeter. You can find out this one, length of one equal side B, if perimeter and A is known, and if perimeter and base is known on equal side, then you can find out the length of equal side, and if A and B are given, so you can find out the height and area directly. Okay, this is all about the isosceles triangle. That means I have told you everything on triangles. Okay, in normal, in general case, I have told you how to find out the area of the triangle, half base unit and the area of the triangle when sides are known. And after that, I have given everything in my previous video about the equilateral triangle. And in this video, I have given all the things on isosceles triangle. So in my next video, I will move to quadrilateral. That means square, rectangle, rhombus, parallelogram, etc. Okay, so I request you to do all the problems which I have given you in the description box. Okay, in the description, I will give you the questions and do the problems. And I request you to give some comments. I am not forcing you to give you positive comments. You may give also negative comments if there is some negative in my teaching or in my videos, then you can also give. And I also request you to give some comments. That means any suggestions. If you want anything more or anything, you are most welcome to give you some suggestions. To give you any suggestion to me. You can give any suggestion. Sir, please do this one, or it will be better if you do like this, or it will be better if the formula will be like this. Anything you can do. You can give comments. Okay. So I will be very much appreciate you if you will give some comments. Okay. So thank you. Thank you very much for watching my class. Thank you. Bye bye.